Abel Sanchez gets checked by a reporter over his statement saying Canelo ran versus Golovkin in the first fight. Stay tuned. Boxing Eagle here. If you like this video, make sure you hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon on the top of your screen to get notified when the latest new content drops. One. What up, fight world? It's your boy Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. Make sure you smash the like button. Also, subscribe to the channel for the latest and greatest in boxing if you want to become part of the gang gang. Notification gang. Please hit the bell icon. Shout out to the Super Chats, channel donations, the Venmo donations, and the Patreon family. We working. Today, the fighters did the grand arrivals. September 15th, this Saturday, it's fight week. Canelo versus Triple G, the rematch. Also, if you're going to be in Vegas, go to the Box Fan Expo. Andre Ward's going to be there. Errol Spence, Mikey Garcia. Should be a great time. Eric Morales, Fernando Vargas. Ton of fighters. If you'd like to purchase tickets, the link is in the description of all of my videos. I'm an affiliate, so it helps the channel. And you can purchase the tickets through Boxing Ego directly. So I look forward to seeing a lot of you guys there. Should be a good event before the main event, Canelo versus Triple G. Now, they did the grand arrivals in Las Vegas, which is customary for the MGM property. You know, big super fights, pay-per-view fights and stuff. And they did like a little round table with reporters afterwards. And Triple G basically made a statement where he said, I'll put the link in the description. I seen it on Fight Hub. And Triple G basically said, they said, was anything that Canelo did better than you expected in the first fight? And he said, hey, yeah, he ran. He said Canelo ran better than that. He didn't expect him to be such a good runner or something. And that kind of opened up a floodgate. Then Abel Sanchez started talking. And a reporter, I believe it's the reporter, one of them from Ring TV, right? He challenged, and you see the title, the Fight Hub's title. It says, Abel Sanchez snaps at reporter for dot, dot, dot. You know, and again, you could watch it for yourself. But the reporter says to Abel, he's like reasoning with him. He's like, Abel, I mean, come on, do you really, I watched the fight four times, Canelo versus Triple G four times. Do you really consider what Canelo did running? And then Abel started, you know, kind of getting defensive and saying, yeah, he accused Mayweather and Edislandi Lada of running. And he was like, yeah, but I wouldn't call that running. He was fighting off the ropes, doing this and that. And then Abel kind of like tried to dead it and like cut him off and says, well, we're the fighters. We're the fighters over here. Like, this is the fight team. You're just a writer, you know, and try to kind of relegate him to you sit behind a desk and write. We're the fighters. We're the actual fighters. We're supposed to be the experts, right? So a bit snarky. And, you know, he just kind of looked away and then, you know, kind of ignored the rest of it. And I heard somebody in the crowd says, yeah, operative word being supposed to be the experts or something like that. So listen, I thought, in my opinion, that was a bit overreaction from Abel Sanchez. I don't know if he has a personal situation with that particular reporter, but I think it's a fair question. And to be honest, I question the same thing. Now, I will give him credit. He did. Canelo did say that Edislandi Lada and Floyd Mayweather ran in their bouts, right? He did accuse him that, you know, because he had trouble searching them and landing shots or whatever. And they were crafty, used some lateral movement. So that part is true. However, if you're really breaking it down, Abel's been on this tirade about how Canelo, hopefully he's a man of his word, sit still, sit there and trade. How are you going to win the fight? You should be trying to win the fight. And how are you going to get a knockout if you don't stand your ground? But if you stand your ground, you're going to get knocked out by Golovkin. You know, Mexican style, just saying the same thing over and over again. And I'm just kind of over it. You know, Canelo, yes, he introduced movement probably more than he has in past fights. But me being a sensible, reasonable boxing fan, neutral, I don't have any horse in the race. I didn't bet on the first fight. I didn't lose money or anything, you know, because I don't think I would have lost money if it was a draw, because nobody technically won. But either way, that running stuff is dead. Like, you know, new media is here. We got to make it make sense. Canelo, it's not his obligation. I'm going to keep saying this. Or anyone else. It's not his obligation to make changes to suit your fighter's style and make it an easier night or a more comfortable night. So your fighter can look sensational and have another Vonis Matarosyan second round knockout because you're playing into his strength. That is not boxing. That's actually stupidity. If you know someone's good at something and you're going to purposely allow for them to be great at that or be good at that by feeding into what they're good at, then you're an idiot. You know, that just, it doesn't make sense. Just like Floyd Mayweather, people, oh, Floyd chicken high, he ran high. I mean, he's this is his fifth division. We never seen the guys. How come the guys he's fighting, this is his fifth division or fourth division. How come the guys he's fighting that are much bigger than him, they haven't moved up four or five divisions? Because majority of them don't have the skill of Floyd Mayweather. So any of the guys, majority of them, if they moved up four or five divisions from where they started, they would be getting knocked the fuck out. Point blank period. Because they don't have the skills or the size or whatever to coexist with people four divisions, five divisions higher than where they started. Floyd is gifted. He is an anomaly, you know? And it's just like people hold certain guys. Of course, he's not going to just sit in front of you and trade with the much bigger Canelo for 12 straight rounds with one look only in this Rock'em Sock'em robot. That wouldn't even make sense. Same thing with Golovkin. This was Canelo's really first fight at 160. You can count the 164.5 fight with Julio Cesar Chavez, but it wasn't even much of a fight. Chavez wasn't even really fighting back. He just kind of made weight and looks like he gave everything on the scale because he just not really a typical Chavez Jr. fight. He barely threw any punches, right? So Canelo just used him as a punching bag for 12 rounds. So really, you have an inexperienced guy at 160 or better, and you want him, and you know, he fought to a draw. You want him to just sit in front of Golovkin, who's been fighting at middleweight since the amateurs, and we know he's strong. It makes absolutely no sense. You look at this from the perspective of even team sports, right? And I'll give you guys a quick analogy. The Golden State Warriors, it's a shooting team. Steph Curry is one of the best shooters in NBA history. You know, he's on the point, on money with the three-pointers and whatnot. So if he's open, he's a problem. He's a danger because he has a quick release and he, bop, Steph Curry with the shot, boy. You know, Splash Brothers, right? He's going to hit buckets. So that's why you sometimes see the Cleveland Cavaliers or somebody who's playing against them at a high level, or let's say a playoff game, championship finals or whatnot, they might put two people to guard Steph Curry because they want him to just pass the ball. They don't want him to be open where he's only being guarded by one person because he's going to be a danger of being able to wiggle out because he's not the biggest guy. He's like maybe 6'1", 6'2", and you know, he has fast feet and stuff like that. He'll get in position, shake you real quick, and then drop a three. So that's why you get two people. Point being is, and the comparison is this, is because we know Steph Curry is a shooter, and why give him the opportunity to shoot if it's an important game? You know, that's why he's getting double teamed. You know, that same thing with LeBron. That's why they double team LeBron, because they don't want him open. They don't want him to be able to drive to the rack, you know, and dunk in the paint and, you know, just be open for certain clutch shots. Same thing with boxing. Why the fuck would you give somebody the opportunity to do what they do best? Now, if it just happens they're the superior fighter and you can't foil their game plan and it happens, that's one thing. But we know Golovkin is strong, so no one's going to just sit there and trade with him. And then the guys that have tried to do that stand their ground, they look mangled and bloody, or they get knocked out like Vonis Matarosyan. So obviously what Canelo and Daniel Jacobs did was a more suitable game plan, because Jacobs did get knocked down, but you notice he never got knocked down again, and I thought he won the fight. Same thing with Canelo. I have to watch it again, but I had Triple G winning by a small margin. The draw, you know, I can understand why people that, because Canelo was more effective and accurate. You know, Triple G was just busier. So what Abel is doing with this whole rhetoric is kind of like making a pre-built-in excuse, and to me it just sounds ridiculous. Time and time again, you just keep talking about Canelo running and you're Mexican, be a true Mexican. Like, there's no true Mexican, you know? You're calling your guy Mexican style. He don't speak Spanish. He doesn't know, like, you know, his roots aren't in Mexican culture, things like that. So it's like, what are we really talking about here? We should all leave this ethnicity and race thing alone. Let Triple G like come up with Kazakhstan style or some shit. That's where he's from. I've never seen Triple G walk out in a Mexican style robe, you know, with the Mexican flag colors. People were like, what the hell? You know, he always has like the traditional Kazakhstan robe, if anything, you know, or maybe just a Triple G robe. But I have seen him with that blue and gold, like Kazakhstan flag robe, you know. So let it be that. Let Canelo fight how he wants to fight. Triple G can fight how he wants to fight. May the best man win. But for Abel to lash out and make it like kind of make a scene like, oh, we're the professionals. People got to stop that. Just because you're the fighter and trainer tandem doesn't mean nobody else knows anything, you know, especially a boxing writer. Not some of them don't know shit about boxing, I give you that, but there's some guys that do know shit about boxing too, and they enjoy it and watch it. But there's a lot of people who just say, oh, you've never been in the ring or blah blah blah, so you don't know nothing. I mean, look at the hypocrisy in that statement, just in the sense of, then you shouldn't be able to judge anything that you haven't done. So for example, I've done music before. I've been in professional studio and laid tracks down, right? So I know the feeling. So how can you judge if so-and-so, Eminem or Big Sean or somebody come out with a rap album, Nicki Minaj, how can you judge it if you never been there? You never been a rapper. You never been in the studio and laced like an EP or LP. So, you know, that's what some people do. Like, oh, you never been a boxing trainer. You never been a boxer. So you have no bearing on what happens. Okay, so how you judge a rap album if you never laced tracks, you know, hook, chorus, melody, interludes, you know, and just been in the studio, you know? And people do this all the time. They act like, I understand boxing is sweet science and not everyone knows about it, but Abel, the way he did it was kind of pompous, making it sound like absolutely nobody, including, like, you just a writer, you don't know anything. We're the fighters, we're supposed to know, we're the experts. That don't make you an expert, you know what I mean, just because you're a trainer. Because I know a lot of trainers that tell their fighters to do stupid shit. I've seen trainers tell, yeah, they're winning the fight, they're talking about get aggressive in the 12th round, and their fighter get knocked out in the 12th round because you told them to give it their all. You know, Chris Algieri's trainer, no disrespect to him, Tim Lee or whatever dude's name was, he said, yeah, I'm gonna let Chris Algieri out the cage, and then Algieri gets knocked the fuck down real hard by Pacquiao. So, you know, I thought it was a bit pompous for Abel to just be like, we're the experts, you know? Again, if you subscribe to that, then how do you judge anything? How do you judge a movie? How do you judge Steven Spielberg's movie or whatever, Christopher Nolan's latest project? You never directed a movie. You don't know how it feels to direct a feature film. So how are you going to judge if the movie was good or bad? You know, all you do is just watch movies and like movies. You know, how you going to judge Nicki Minaj's album when you can't spit? When you never been in the studio and recorded a full length album? You know, so I get what people are saying when they say that, but then again, it's still hypocritical, because there's a lot of things that people do on a day-to-day basis and judge, like politics or whatever. You've never been a politician, you've never been a governor, you've never been this, you never had, so how do you have an opinion on it, you know? So for Abel to take that kind of tone, it was just, to me, it was overkill. And I'm just, you know, to be honest, I feel like this fight is lacking some of the buzz, and I think this is kind of why. You know, it's just people are, I just want to see the fight. I want a clear-cut conclusion, and I want to be done with it, to be honest. Because I'm sick of this running shit. I'm sick of, like, the drug controversy. It's, you know, it's like the fight is almost, just like the meat, it's the fight is kind of tainted a bit. You know, just with all the BS surrounding it and statements and stuff. I just kind of want to see it, be done with this week, and then, you know, enjoy the rest of the boxing year. Let me know what you guys think of Abel Sanchez getting checked by the reporter, who basically challenged that Canelo didn't run. Link in the description. Make sure you smash the like button as always. Hate, comment, and subscribe. Till next video, it's Ego Center. So if you enjoyed this video and want more content like this on the channel, you can show your appreciation by going to the PayPal donate button or the YouTube support button, and you can donate any amount that you feel is equivalent to the value of this video. Much more to come. Thank you guys for your support. Boxing Ego, the future of boxing.